why I'm dressed the same, because I filmed it straight after. Surprise, surprise. And this is my body moisturiser, skincare favourite. So I got 4 body moisturisers that I absolutely love, and I've also got 2 hand creams that I'm going to talk to you about as well. I'll start with body moisturisers. The first 3 you probably will have heard of, the last one slightly more high end. The first one is the Vaseline body moisturiser in cocoa butter. I do also use this in a spray form, which I actually much prefer. It's much easier to use. However, I don't have any of that available for me to show you right now, but I have the cream version of it. This cocoa butter has got vitamin E in it, and it's just really, really soft and smooth to rub onto the skin. It absorbs really quickly into the skin, and it just smells beautiful. Everyone knows what the Vaseline cocoa butter smells like. If you don't know what it smells like, go and find one and smell it, because it's a really good smell. It's also, I found this one is really, really good for sensitive skin, so people with maybe eczema or other skin problems. My other 3, not so much, but this one definitely definitely suitable for sensitive skin as well. It's just really, really gentle and really nice to use. Another one that you will all have heard of, I'm pretty sure, is the Soap and Glory The Righteous Butter. This pot is massive and it looks like I've hardly touched it, but again, I've had this for like, oh, I just love the smell of this so much. I've had this for nearly 2 years, maybe? I'm literally not even halfway through it. Although, to be fair, I do use a lot of different body moisturisers. I change it up every time I use it. I'll use a different one. Don't ask me why, I just do. But this one is really, really rich and really moisturising. Definitely not for the sensitive skin, as there's lots of perfumes in it. And I know a couple of people that have got eczema that can't use Soap and Glow products. They should bring out a sensitive range for sensitive skin, but obviously the good thing about Soap and Glory is the smells. That's probably what affects the skin the most, is the perfumes that's in it. But as a body moisturiser, this is beautiful. I'm pretty sure you've all tried it. Am I correct? Most probably. The smell lingers with this one for absolutely ages. Like, I'll put it on after my bath or shower and I will still smell it, like throughout the day or in the morning. If I had a bath in the evening and then used this, I would still smell this in the morning. And that's what I love about the Soap and Glory products, is their scents are just lovely. And this one in particular has shea butter and aloe vera in it, which are wonderful on the skin. I really love products that have got aloe vera in. She says that this is the only one that I've got currently that has aloe vera in, but I do really, really like aloe vera. My skin likes aloe vera as well. Next is definitely more of a summer scent, but I really, really like the moisturiser itself. It's the it's one from the Body Shop, and it is one of their body butters. And this one is Satsuma, and I can't open it. And it just smells literally like a fresh orange. It smells just like you've peeled an orange or you've just eaten an orange. I absolutely love this moisturiser. I've only got a little pot because this was actually a free sample. They had a thing where if you spent a certain amount, you've got to do like a lucky dip prize, and I got this. My favourite thing about this one probably is the smell of it. I'm quite attracted to citrusy scents, but it is really moisturising, it is. But if you are like me and you're more attracted to a smell, I would definitely go for the Body Shop ones. They have so many different scents in there. Body butters, so go and check them out. More of a high-end moisturiser. It is Penhaligon's Elenicia. I think that's how it's said. Elenicia. It's a hand and body cream. The smell of this one, it's a very individual smell. That's the only way I can describe it. I really like it, but it's very different. And I think with Penhaligon's, all their scents, everyone has their own one that they really like, but they're all quite strong and they're all very, I don't know, I think they're all very different kind of scents. But the Elenicia is my favourite, and I've had to get it up because I can't actually remember what's in it, and I'm opening this tab, that would not be good. It contains aloe vera. I did just say that I don't have another one with aloe vera in it. That was a lie, I do, this one does. Shea butter, cocoa seed butter, sweet almond oil. It is so moisturising, it is crazy. All of their moisturisers are so good. I would really, really recommend them. If you, it's coming up to Christmas, if you are really wanting a treat, I'll go pop in to see the lovely people in Penhaligon's, and they will help you out. I mean, they will find your perfect scent for you. They do it with the perfumes. You can go in and have like, I can't remember what they call it. I don't know. They will show you all the perfumes and find the one that matches your skin perfectly. So obviously everybody's skin reacts differently to different perfumes and moisturisers, and everything smells different on other people because of their body chemicals. And that's one thing that I absolutely love about Penhaligon's. It's very, very personal service. They will find the perfect thing for you, and Elenicia was it for me. And I'm so glad because I do really, really like the smell. I use this when I'm feeling very luxurious and I want to really treat myself. I'll use this. I have so much left of it because I hardly ever use it. I mean, I've got this bottle and I've also got this one, but you can see how long I've had it because look at the difference in the colour of it. I sit this on my dressing table so the sun's kind of bleached it a little bit. But I've got about half of this one left and I still have a whole one here. All-time favourite moisturiser is definitely this one. Eve's Washer in Cocoa and Orange. You will have seen this before, I think. I might have had it in a favourites, or I've had it in a video before, but it smells just like Terry's Chocolate Orange. And this is the perfect time of year to start using this. It just makes me think of Christmas all the time. Every time I use it, I'll stand there and just smell my hands. I absolutely love this. And this is my throw in the bag hand cream. Without fail, it will be in a bag that I'm carrying with me. Another one that I really like to use that I don't have with me is the Soap and Glory hand feed, but I don't use that one as much. I just find that the Eve's Washer one is much better on my hands, and it's really good on my nails as well. I don't find the Soap and Glory one quite so nice on like my cuticles and things like that. Hand creams for me have to be able to moisturise like your nail beds and things as well, and the Eve's Washer one really does that, and it just smells so good. Again, like in my last one, I will link everything that I've mentioned down below for you so you can go check it out yourself. I really hope you've liked these two videos. I find them really useful to see like what people favour to use in different times of year. That was right, wasn't it? To see what people favour to use during different seasons and things, you know what I'm trying to say. And it always, whenever I watch them, my shopping list just grows all the time for me to go and buy things to try. As before, social media links are all down below, and I'll see you next time. Bye!